The onboard crew is in the early afternoon of their crew day. They have a wide range of tasks today, including station hardware configurations, departure preparations, and experiment work. Ron Guerin and Mike Fossum have just completed a news conference with journalists from the Johnson Space Center and Kennedy Space Center. Questions included the crew's thoughts regarding the Russian spacecraft, as well as the fragility of the planet and the value of continuous human presence on the space station. Guerin will now resume preparations for his return to Earth next week, packing up supplies and equipment. He will return to Earth with Andrei Borisenko and Alexander Samokutayev in the Soyuz TMA-21 spacecraft early next Friday. Later in his afternoon, Guerin will also work on the Human Research Facility, preparing for a DVD load transfer. Guerin and Fossum will end the day with routine private medical conferences, and then they and Satoshi Furukawa will also participate in the reaction self-test. That is a portable 5-minute reaction time test that allows the crew members to monitor the daily effects of fatigue and performance while on board the space station.
Yeah, go ahead.
Mike, I got caught with a little bit of blockage before that teeter's handover before I could correct my last call. The second pass, cupola window number 4 is actually going to be better than window number 1.
Yeah, copy that. And you guys don't need to give us windows. Just port or starboard is all we need, and that'll be totally cool. The window kind of changes as you're going by and stuff.
Copy that. Thanks for the info.
Again, a bit of an update there from the onboard crew to the Capcom.
And I had a follow-up question. Did you guys confirm that the State Park fast drop is one of the directly affected areas with the fire in that region?
Station Houston, yes, Mike, unfortunately that's true. The news agencies are reporting up to 2/3 of the park has been burned and hundreds of homes in the area have been destroyed.
Oh, wow. Wow, that's rough news. Thanks. We're really thinking about all those folks through there.
Copy that, Mike. And the COTS lab is working on getting some information up to you via your web pages.
Some words there to NASA astronaut Mike Fossum, who's an avid outdoorsman. He is a experienced scout leader and hiker. He had inquired earlier of the flight control team about any of the wildfire damage that's been occurring in Texas, including some of his favorite areas there. As relayed by Jay Marshke, the Capcom on duty, there has been some impacts to that area. The flight control teams also researched photo opportunities of the wildfires. They do anticipate some possible viewing opportunities in the next hour or so. We'll certainly be relaying those as well via our website. Fossum is deactivating television equipment following the crew news conference that was recently completed. The rest of his afternoon includes connecting some of the umbilical lines for one of the Express Science racks, then exercise on the treadmill and water recovery system maintenance. The crew will end their day with a daily planning conference at 1:50 p.m. Central Time, followed by off-duty time. They're scheduled for crew sleep at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. The crew woke at 1 a.m. Central Time, which is their standard start of day. They had their morning inspection, and then some routine body mass measurements were part of an ongoing study of changes in the body mass for long-duration crew members. They also had some personal time for breakfast and hygiene before their start-of-day daily planning conference. The morning tasks included work on HDTV configurations by Satoshi Furukawa, and also he performed a scenario of onboard diagnostic kit demonstration or ultrasound work, which is a part of a medical experiment. Mike Fossum continued with troubleshooting of the ARID, or Advanced Resistive Exercise Device display, and also took about an hour to exercise on that device. He also worked on removal of payload-related cargo stored in the PMM, or the Permanent Multipurpose Module. This again, a current view of the International Space Station. Just within the last hour, the external cameras mounted on the vehicle were able to capture some views of the hurricane. We can replay some of that footage for you. Again, captured just about 45 minutes ago as external cameras captured video of Hurricane Katia as it moved northwest across Western Atlantic, north of Puerto Rico. This occurred at 10:35. Eastern time on earlier today. Katia has strengthened into a major Category 3 hurricane, packing winds of 125 miles per hour, and could strengthen even more before taking a northern and then northeastern track east of the east coast of the United States.